Hi Angel here for tabletblog.de. I just got the over-the-air update for Honeycomb for my HTC Flyer. The HTC Flyer was released in May or June, I think in May, and it came with Gingerbread. Now a couple of months later, in December, they released a Honeycomb tablet, Android 3.2 Honeycomb, with their HTC Sense UI for tablets. And that's basically the reason why we don't see a lot of changes compared to the HTC Flyer with Gingerbread because of HTC Sense. But there are a couple of changes more in the background, but in the UI a little bit of too, of course. First of all, we've got this new bar here on the bottom, and originally, and we still have three buttons here, three capacitive buttons for the home, menu, and back. But when I installed Honeycomb, there was a message from HTC that I can't use these three buttons here and here no more. They're not supported under Honeycomb. So, yeah, they're useless now. I mean, it's not a big problem because we have these three buttons here now, but they're still there. We just can't use them. The HTC Scribe button still works for the pen input. We'll have a closer look at that in a couple of seconds or minutes. And yeah, we see that HTC changed a lot compared to vanilla Honeycomb. These buttons have a different style and different color, and these notifications as well. Looks a little bit different. If we go to the settings, this looks different. Actually, it looks the same like the Gingerbread HTC Flyer, but compared to the Honeycomb settings, it looks a lot different. Here we see Android 3.2 Honeycomb and HTC Sense 1.1 for tablets. Okay, let's get out of it. That's HTC Sense. The UI hasn't changed a lot, the home screen UI. We still have a couple of home screens and this 3D effect if we scroll through them very fast. We still have the HTC Sense widget like Friends Stream and so on. And actually we've got a couple of other ones. Like here this message and calculator widgets, Twitter widgets, and we've got a couple of widgets that were new with Honeycomb. I think they were at the beginning. They included a couple of new setting widgets, shortcuts for the brightness and Wi-Fi, 3G, and so on. They weren't included in the Gingerbread software, the Gingerbread HTC Sense UI before. They are new. Basically because in Gingerbread we had this bar that we can pull out with a lot of settings. Of course we've got a couple of settings here, but you have to press twice. There was only one slide in Gingerbread, and I think that's the reason why they included a couple of new widgets, or just because they liked it. Okay, we've got a different resolution than on most Honeycomb tablets. This one here is 1024x600. Normally we have 1280x800, but as far as I've seen since now, there's not a problem with apps or something. Everything works fine, even the Honeycomb apps. Here we see as well that there is a little bit change in the UI compared to Honeycomb. It just looks a little bit different. Let's open the browser. That's the standard Honeycomb browser. In the background, we just have a UI on top from HTC. It's pretty similar to the normal HTC Sense. Normally this one is black, now it's blue, but there's not much a difference here in the browser UI. Let's go to a website. The keyboard is the same HTC Sense keyboard, not the Honeycomb one. Let's just open a website. I'm uploading a video in the background, so the Wi-Fi is a little bit slow right now. That's not because of Honeycomb, but the browser already see it. It's not lagging or something. We can now test the scrolling and multi-touch, but it works everything fine like on most other Honeycomb tablets. It's still loading a little bit, but as you can see, it works fine. What we did not have before, I said it is a little bit takes some time to render if you use the multi-touch to zoom. On the Gingerbread, it didn't had this background here, this blue background, and it rendered a little bit faster. But basically, everything works fine in the browser. Yeah, let's test the HTC Scribe. Again, nothing much has changed here. It still works. Just on the Honeycomb now. Yeah, the UI, HTC Sense 1.1 for tablets looks pretty nice, but it took HTC from May to December to release Honeycomb, and if it takes them as long to release Ice Cream Sandwich, you will see us again in half a year. But I hope they will be faster, but maybe they aren't releasing Ice Cream Sandwich, we don't know, they haven't announced anything yet. But yeah, Honeycomb on the HTC Player looks good, nothing that much game changing. It's Honeycomb with the HTC Sense UI, like on the HTC Jetstream.